Good evening and welcome to the Brooklyn Public Library. I'm Isaac Fitzgerald and I'm thrilled to be your host tonight as we celebrate the Brooklyn Public Library Prize for 2020. And even though we are not able to be together tonight and many of you are joining in from home, I have made my way to the Park Slope branch of the Brooklyn Library so I could bring the library to you. I know many of you are tuning in tonight because, like me, you love the library and the joy of a good book. And tonight, you have a chance to win all six of the shortlisted books along with an annual membership to Al's Cocktail Club, which, if you were not at the cocktail hour that we just had, I can vouch that Al's cocktails are quite good. But you'll get an annual membership to Al's Cocktail Club and a chance to win all six of the shortlisted books. And you can enter by signing up, by renewing or signing up for the first time, your Brooklyn Eagles membership. All the information is at the bottom of your screen. So just go there. Please, if you're a new member, we would love to welcome you into the Brooklyn Eagles family. And of course, if you're already a member, you already know why you should renew your membership. Tonight, we are here to honor the winners of the 2020 Brooklyn Public Library Literary Prize, presented by the Brooklyn Eagles. And I know there are many Brooklyn Eagles in the house tonight. Thank you so much for joining us. This prize is special in many ways, but none more so than the selection committee, comprised entirely of librarians, the people who know more about books than just about anyone. In fact, librarians from across the borough nominated 110 books this year, looking for writing that could spark conversation and bring Brooklynites closer together in a year when we have too often been very, very far apart. Librarians read books, made recommendations, served on juries, met online, and perhaps most importantly, will share the nominated books with patrons for many months to come. On a personal note, I just want to thank all of the librarians out there, especially during this very hard and difficult year. So many people, so many families, so many Brooklynites have relied on library services, and you all have risen above and beyond. Your work is so important. My best friend's mother growing up was a librarian. She kept me out of a lot of trouble. So I have a large place in my heart for librarians. So thank you. Now, this year's nominees for the Brooklyn Public Library Literary Prize included memoirs, essays, novellas, novels, poetry, and nonfiction by veteran and debut authors alike. The staggering breadth of the stories they tell reflect the profound challenges facing our nation and help us escape to other fantastical universes when our own world seems to be a little too much. They will join the library's collection, already strong with 4 million items, where they are sure to inform and delight readers for many years. In just a few moments, you will hear from some of those librarians, but first, it is my honor to welcome a very special guest. Please welcome Linda Johnson, the president and CEO of Brooklyn Public Library. Let's give it up. Go ahead. You can get louder.
And welcome, everyone. We originally hoped to host the 2020 Brooklyn Classic right here at the brand new Greenpoint Library and Environmental Education Center. We rebuilt this library with funding from the Greenpoint Community Environmental Fund, which was part of the state's settlement with ExxonMobil for polluting in this very neighborhood. It's a parable that I've held on tightly to this year, that an oil spill led to a neighborhood library covered in solar panels with a rooftop pollinator garden, that times of great difficulty can lead to crucial change. All the writers we're celebrating this evening perform a similar alchemy. Whether they are poets or professors, journalists or sci-fi novelists, each of their books observe injustice with careful attention, and in so doing, bring something else from it, truth and beauty, compassion and connection. Each of their books asks us to examine how our world has come to be, and in so doing, how we might imagine it differently. Tonight, we honor the work of writers as essential and the work of librarians as essential too. We are grateful to Mark Daly and the selection committee librarians who vigorously debated, I kid you not, 110 nominated titles. And to all the BPL librarians who, against the odds of 2020, have worked to ensure that readers across our borough can continue to learn and connect with one another, even in the midst of extreme isolation and uncertainty. We are also grateful to the Brooklyn Eagles for their unflagging belief in the library's democratic mission. Thank you to the hosts committee for helping us transform our annual party into a virtual one, especially Emily Ashton and Divya Sastry. Our sincere thanks to the Peck Stackpool Foundation for making the prize possible. And thanks to our generous sponsors, Wandering Barman, Six Point Brewery, Q Mixers, and Van Brunt Stillhouse. Though having to rely on emoji applause is a bit disappointing, we know that it's no less enthusiastic than it would be in other years. Finally, thank you for tuning in with us this evening, from wherever you are, to uplift art and uplift public libraries, and to insist on their importance as we seek to heal our community and our country. I lift my proverbial glass to you. I hope you have a wonderful evening, and I turn it back to you, Isaac.
Thank you so much, Linda. Go ahead, you can clap it up. Give it up for Linda. Absolutely wonderful, absolutely wonderful. It's now my great pleasure to welcome two of the library's most enthusiastic supporters, the Brooklyn Eagles and classic co-chairs, Emily Ashton and Divya Sastry.
I'm Emily Ashton.
And I'm Divya Sastry.
Together, we co-chair the Brooklyn Eagles and tonight's Brooklyn Classic. It's so wonderful to see so many of you here tonight. Many of you have been celebrating with us at this event for the past 7 years, and we never imagined hosting a virtual event. But here we are in 2020, and we are so grateful for your flexibility, enthusiasm, and generous support of the Brooklyn Public Library through the Classic. Before we get to the big event tonight, announcing our 2020 Brooklyn Public Library Lit Prize winners, I want to tell you a little bit about the Brooklyn Eagles, the group of supporters who are hosting this great event.
Libraries are among the most democratic institutions. Welcome to all who aim to advance their lives. We are very fortunate to have a world-class library system in Brooklyn, and the mission of the Eagles is to keep that system strong. The Brooklyn Eagles support the library by volunteering, raising funds, and pitching in on projects at our local branches. Since the Eagles were founded 7 years ago, we've planted a library garden, given away hundreds of trees, hosted dozens of membership events, signed up hundreds of kids for Brooklyn Public Library's summer reading program, read many a book, and have raised over $500,000 to support the library's essential free programs and learning opportunities for all Brooklynites.
And since March, we've quickly transitioned to temporary but vibrant virtual and socially distanced activities. We've discussed 4 books on Zoom as part of our book clubs. We've hosted a virtual beer tasting. We've cheered on our librarians on a bike ride to branches across Brooklyn. And of course, we planned this event. We'd like to thank our fellow Eagles for their service. And we'd also like all Eagles who are here tonight to please write a note in the chat saying, "Go Eagles." Thank you. If you aren't yet an Eagle, we encourage you to join tonight. Memberships start at just $50. And as you heard Isaac announce earlier this evening, you will be entered into a raffle to win a stack of all 6 shortlisted books, as well as an annual membership to Al's Cocktail Club.
Many of you signed up at this very event last year, which means it's probably time to renew your membership. You can join at brooklynlibrary.org/support, and the link will also be posted below. Thanks again to everyone on our host committee and to all of you who are here to support the Brooklyn Public Library.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you so much, Divya, and thank you, Emily. That was so wonderful. They do such incredible work and they make events like tonight happen. So again, don't forget, if you're interested in becoming a Brooklyn Eagle, please join the family. And if you are an Eagle, it might be time to renew that membership. So check in on that. And now we're gonna take a little bit of a moment. It's the equivalent of a library bragging a little bit. We're gonna look at some of the winners from past years. What a wonderful, incredible collection of books. Listen, I truly, as a reader, all those books that were just listed, they're absolutely fantastic. If you're looking for something to read while we're all kind of in a little bit of a lockdown or quarantine situation, you could do a lot worse than some of those books that were just listed, all right? Now, I know we just had that a little bit, but I wanna brag a little bit more. I love to big up people. I love to talk about other people's accomplishments. So I am going to tell you what some of our past winners and nominees have gone on to do because they are incredible and extraordinary things. 2018 winner Carmen Maria Machado is producing a television series for FX based on her short story collection, which is fantastic, Her Body and Other Parties. 2017 winner Richard Rothstein's The Color of Law became a New York Times bestseller this summer with the increased national attention on racial injustice. The book is now regularly named as essential reading. 2017 finalists, David Grand's book, Killers of the Flower Moon, The Osag Murders, and The Birth of the FBI, is being adapted into a film to be directed by Martin Scorsese, starring Leonardo DiCaprio and Robert De Niro. And here's a fun fact, I remember dancing with David Grand at the 2017 Brooklyn Classic. Maybe he wasn't dancing, but I definitely was on him just a little bit. So we're incredibly thrilled to hear that. 2017 winner Tommy Pico is shooting up the podcast charts with his extremely popular podcast, Food for Thought, and is writing for the FX series, Reservation Dogs. 2017 finalist Kim Phillips Fine's book, Fear City, was also a finalist for a little prize known as the Pulitzer Prize in history. And following the publication of 2016 winner Mary E. Busser's Lockdown on Rikers, and after years of lobbying by prison reform activists, Mayor de Blasio announced a plan to permanently shut down the jail on Rikers Island by 2027. 2016 finalist James McBride's 2020 novel, Deacon King Kong, is a national bestseller and an Oprah's Book Club pick. Six finalists went on to win national book awards. And 2019 finalist N.K. Jemison and 2019 winner Tressie McMillan Cottenham were awarded MacArthur Genius Grants this past fall, which is incredible and so, so deserved. These amazing awards and honors and the work the winners and nominees accomplished after winning the Brooklyn Public Library Literary Prize just shows how tuned in librarians are to the pulse of the nation and the communities in which they serve. You would be hard pressed to find better readers than librarians. And now it is my pleasure to introduce the 2019 winner for nonfiction, Dr. Tressie McMillan Cottam. Her book, Thick, and Other Essays, which, as all these books are, but Thick, so, so good, is a critically acclaimed bestseller about beauty, money, media, gender, inequality, and so much more. In addition to winning the Brooklyn Public Library Literary Prize, Thick was shortlisted for the 2019 National Book Award in Nonfiction. Is it any wonder that she recently was named, this past fall, a MacArthur Foundation Fellow? Please welcome Dr. Tressie McMillan Cottam.
Hello, everyone. I am Tressie McMillan Cottam. I'm a writer, a sociologist, a professor, 2020 MacArthur Fellow, and for our purposes here today especially, I am the honored recipient of the Brooklyn Public Literary Prize for Thick and Other Essays. The literary prize from Brooklyn Public Library was the first major award for this book and for me, which was an extreme honor. I'd spend quite a bit of time in and around Brooklyn when promoting this book, maybe for obvious reasons. I've got a lot of readers in that area. There are a lot of readers there, period. And you would be surprised, or maybe not so surprised, by how many people had found this book through the public library. And that means something in particular to me. I grew up, as many people did, finding a home intellectually and culturally in my local library. It was one of the things that my mother and I did together regularly, walking to the local library in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And having my very own library card was the first sign of maturity that I can remember, because it meant I had control over where my imagination went. It was a kind of freedom and autonomy that matters to everyone, but it means something in particular, I think, for a little Black girl to have that kind of control and sense of purpose, that I could build my own intellectual world because a library card gave that to me. I could walk into the library and I could read anything I wanted. And when I learned I didn't have to stay in the children's section, I could go to the adult section. I could read the big people's books. I came up with all of these ways to choose my next read. I read the book that had the red cover. I read the book that had the thickest spine. I read the book that had the prettiest colors on the front. I could choose, though, how I interacted with the world. I could make a decision about what I would read. And in many ways, that determined the freedom I felt about determining who I would become. And so libraries mean a great deal to me, which is why today I'm now a professor in the School of Information and Library Sciences at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill. It is my great honor and privilege to count libraries, librarians, and library patrons among my intellectual and spiritual home. And so it meant a great deal to have this book recognized by Brooklyn Public Library. And it has been a wonderful jumping off point for this book's trajectory, as it has gone on to have a life outside of me and beyond me. Like many previous winners, the book has found a home among audiences that I really could not have imagined. And I think the acknowledgement of it as a valuable contribution to the library community and the community of patrons made that difference.
Let's give it up for Dr. Cottam. Come on. That was incredible. What a speech. Go ahead, you can get loud. You can get loud wherever you are, because I agree with her so much. Libraries are a beautiful and a wonderful and a sacred space and so important for learning. And I need to say, I feel lucky to be here right now in the Park Slope branch of the Brooklyn Public Library. I do wish you all were here with me, but it's really fun to be able to bring a little bit of the library there into your homes. But this is it. What we've all been waiting for here, all right? We are going to get into this year's nominees and winners. First, let's start. Here are the 2020 shortlist nominees. Thank you. And again, I'm just going to say it, congratulations to all of the nominees. All of those books are absolutely fantastic. And like I've been saying all evening, were hand-selected by so many thoughtful librarian readers. But now to announce the winner of the 2020 Brooklyn Public Library Literary Prize for Nonfiction, please welcome librarian Robert Weinstein.
Thank you, Isaac. The winner in this year's nonfiction category garnered praise in every step of the nomination process, starting with the librarian who nominated the book and who aptly described it as a book that everyone should read. It is my pleasure to present the Brooklyn Public Literary Prize for Nonfiction to Dr. Ruha Benjamin for her book, Race After Technology, Abolitionist Tools for the New Jim Code. Race After Technology is a book that looks at how technology, from the apps on our phones to the algorithms that guide our search and social media experiences, contain the same prejudices ingrained in our social and political systems. In a video I found on this very same compromised internet, Dr. Benjamin said that the book was designed to call attention to, quote, discriminatory design. That is, the human decisions, assumptions, values that shape the process of tech development, unquote. But it was the immediacy of this book that really stands out. It was not lost on us that although it was nominated before COVID had spread, and while George Floyd was still alive, we were reviewing it in the midst of a pandemic and amid continuing demonstrations about the ways our country endangers the lives of people of color. In other words, it is a critical book for this year and for these times. The book raises awareness of the way technology is weaponized against communities of color and dehumanizes people of other races, ethnicities, and religions. We admired this book for the ways that it made us look at our own complicity in using certain technologies and forced us to respond by saying, okay, now that I know this, I can make different choices. Dr. Benjamin points out that in writing Race After Technology, she hopes to create a language that will allow the communities that she cares about to see the harm being done to them by technology. And in creating this language, she aims to empower those who feel undermined and undone by the status quo. The nonfiction committee is proud to help bring her language to our communities. Congratulations, Dr. Benjamin.
Thank you so much to the Brooklyn Public Library and the 2020 Award Committee for selecting Race After Technology for this incredible honor. No words fully describe what it means to have my work recognized by librarians and the BPL in particular. Growing up in Los Angeles, my elementary school, Angeles Mesa, was directly across the street from a small branch of the LA Public Library. To this day, I remember the feeling of standing in front of a huge wooden desk while the librarian scanned my big stack of books. I can't recall the titles of the books, but I vividly remember the feeling of being entrusted to take this stack of valuables out of the building and bring them back. I felt entrusted, responsible, and grown up. As an adult, my love of libraries has grown. 6 years ago, I was getting ready to move my family to Princeton, New Jersey. And as a city girl, I really wasn't sure I'd like it here. But then I stumbled upon the Princeton Public Library website and noticed the programming. Things like continuing conversations on race and white supremacy held every month, Black Voices Book Club, and the Mercer County Community ID program for our undocumented neighbors. And I thought, wow, this isn't the Princeton I was expecting. If these are the types of programs on offer to the community, then this is a very different community than I had imagined. And sure enough, that hunch was proven correct. Libraries are the heart of any community. They're places where our youngest members first get a taste of being trustworthy. They're also places where grown folks can feel connected and supported. Brooklyn Public Library in particular has a special place in my heart. One of my dearest friends from college was a senior librarian at Macon Library, one of Brooklyn's original Carnegie libraries built in 1907. Tanea Gethers Muhammad started working at BPL in 2003 and was named a 2015 mover and shaker by the Library Journal for her commitment and contributions to the profession. At the time of her award, BPL President and CEO Linda Johnson noted that Tanea, quote, believes libraries belong to the people they serve, and she has earned the affection and respect of her patrons and her inclusive community-focused approach to librarianship. Known affectionately as Miss T to her patrons, Tanea was a teacher, sociologist, researcher, historian, and the librarian who would meet you at Dance Dance Revolution. In Tanea's words, my specialty is serving the youth, though I like to wrap my arms around the entire community. In 2004, I got to see Tanea in action when I participated in an event at MACON that she organized with the family of Miss Henrietta Lacks. I remember thinking as she moved the audience with her amazing storytelling, librarians are truly the modern day griot. On November 14th, 2017, almost exactly 3 years ago, Tanea passed away of a rare condition, neuromyelitis optica, at the age of 37. She was an incredible mother to her four beautiful daughters, wife to Youssef Muhammad, friend and sister to so many, and Brooklyn librarian extraordinaire. I dedicate this award to the memory of Tanea Gethers Muhammad, and I'm donating the award money to start a scholarship in her name, the Tanea Gethers Muhammad Memorial Scholarship at Spelman College. For more information on how to contribute, please see the pinned post on my Twitter profile, Ruha, R-U-H-A, the number 9. With that, thank you to BPL for this incredible honor, and long live all librarians for the people. Ashe.
What a beautiful, beautiful speech. And what a beautiful, beautiful way to use the winning. Dr. Benjamin, thank you for that speech, and thank you for the work that you continue to do. Truly, it's one of my favorite things about this award. It's one of the reasons why I've hosted this awards program before in the past. It's one of my favorite events out of the whole entire year, and it's because we get to listen to brilliant people talk about what libraries and what librarians mean to them. And it's just so moving and so beautiful as that speech was. So again, congratulations, Dr. Benjamin, and of course to all of the nonfiction nominees. And now I am pleased to introduce librarian Madeline Knight Dixon to announce the winner of the 2020 Brooklyn Public Library Literary Prize for Fiction and Poetry.
Thanks, Isaac. At its heart, the winning book is about stories. Whose stories are being told, who gets to tell them, and recognizes the power of storytelling. And so, it is my pleasure to announce the prize for fiction to Ocean Vuong for his work, On Earth Were Briefly Gorgeous. Ocean Vuong's beautiful prose evokes the subtle and profound connections between people, illuminating intermingled joy and pain in a queer coming-of-age story about what it means to know oneself and to see people for who they really are. There is no one way to describe this novel. It's a novel about the queer experience, about the immigrant experience. It's a story about living through generational and personal trauma, a story about first love, healing, and the myriad of ways that our family's legacy defines us. All these stories come together to create a novel that is both shattering and healing. One of the librarians on the committee put it best when she said, "There is such light in this book. It shows those of us on the margins that while we learn to hate ourselves, we can also find love, tenderness, and strength despite the pain." On Earth Were Briefly Gorgeous is a powerful work of art, beautifully told, and we are honored to announce it as the winner of the Brooklyn Public Library's Literary Prize for Fiction.
Hello, my name is Ocean Vuong, and I just want to say deep gratitude and thanks for receiving the Brooklyn Library Award for On Earth Were Briefly Gorgeous. It's a true honor to receive this recognition from a library, and a library that's so important to me, no less. The Brooklyn being the seat of where my career began, my education as a writer began. I graduated from Brooklyn College, and so I know, you know, Grand Army Plaza, and the park, and the museum, the library. It comes full circle. You know, it's a bit of a cliche to say so, but I think, you know, those things exist because it's true. And I, you know, as a writer who comes from a working class background, who, you know, doesn't have access most of my life to books, you know, a book, especially like a hardback book, it's a lot of money. And libraries, I think, like the Brooklyn Public Library, makes it possible for writers like myself to engage in books and to have access to this great wealth of knowledge in order so that we can take our careers, our aspirations and dreams into our own hands. And I really honestly say, I try not to be hyperbolic, but you know, I wouldn't be here without libraries. The access to libraries helped me catch up. And someone who grows up from an underserved community, who doesn't have you know, parents who know about the education system to foster your ambitions, we depend on libraries to catch up, because we do need to catch up. We're so behind in our reading. And, you know, having a library like the Brooklyn College, the Brooklyn College Library, but also the Brooklyn Public Library, support this book is extra special to me. And I hope that I can meet this prize with the ambition to innovate and the challenges therein in my future works. And I hope to live up to this thing, because prizes often are awarded for books already written, but to me, they affirm and they ask for the promise to do even better. And so that's what I hope to do in my next projects, is to meet and to satisfy the great faith that this prize awards a writer. And I'll be sure to be going right back to the libraries to do so. Thank you.
Congratulations, Ocean, what a beautiful, beautiful speech. And Ocean Vuong, I just have to say also, to accept the award, there are certain silver linings to the moment we're in. And that is that we get to watch Ocean accept the award with a dog at their side, wearing a Thrasher sweatshirt, which really meant a lot to me. But that was an absolutely beautiful book and an absolutely beautiful speech. And again, I know I said it after Dr. Benjamin, but one of the most wonderful things about this award is getting to hear how authors and writers got to where they are today because of the hard work of librarians and everybody else that puts in the work, IT workers, security, staff, custodial, all of these different people that go into making a library the very beautiful and special place that it is. So again, to all the administrators, all the librarians, everyone throughout, from top to bottom, thank you so much. And of course, congratulations to Ocean Vuong and to all the nominees tonight. You all absolutely crushed it. Look at all of the books that were nominated. They are well worth your time. The Brooklyn Public Library Literary Prize is a testament to the essential work, of course, of librarians and writers. In the midst of this difficult year, especially, books have helped us to understand complex questions and ideas, to connect to one another, even as we are spending most of our time at home, and even at our most optimistic moments, to imagine a brighter future. Finally, I want to take a moment to thank Charles Duhigg and Ashley Milbach, the Eagles and BPL Lit Prize founders, Thank you so much. Obviously, because of your work and your ability to launch this is why we are here tonight. And if you've enjoyed this event and want to know what you can do to support the amazing work that BPL does for the community, for our great borough here, Kings County, baby, in Brooklyn, join the Eagles tonight. Don't hesitate. It starts at $50 for a membership. The link is BKLYN. That's BKLYN.org/join Eagles. And thinking about the future in our community, may we all hopefully be here in this space next year together, able to dance, able to enjoy each other's company. But I do have to say that this evening was such a special night. This was such a wonderful event, and it means the world that you took the time to show up, to listen to these speeches, and again, all of your support to all of the Brooklyn Eagles out there, to everybody that either donates money or time with the library. It means the world to us. So hopefully next year we will be dancing here in person, but tonight, enjoy yourselves. Feel free to put on some music in your house. Get up and dance a little bit, whether you're with loved ones or by yourself. Make yourself one of the last cocktails from the cocktail hour previously, and I hope to see you next year. Give yourselves a round of applause. Thank you so much. Congratulations to all the winners. We'll see you next year. Thank you.